Now that we have installed R, it's probably a good time to get an idea how to use this program. And the first thing that you should make sure when you have started up R and start using it is to make sure that you're in the right working directory. That means R is expecting you to that you are in a specific directory on your file system, and whatever is loaded into R or saved from R, it goes directly to this working directory, or this is used as a root for every command that you are doing. And to get an idea what your current working directory is, you can type in your first command in R, and that's get wd, which means get working directory. And you can see here that I'm within the folder of the course right now. I might like to change this to going to the directory of the second session, so I could set the working directory with the command set wd, and then type in the relative path to this working directory, which is 02 session 2. And when I then repeat get working directory, you can see that I've changed the working directory to the desired one. Here was now already a bit of magic going on, and I would like to explain that to you a bit. The first thing is there is auto-completion available in the console here. So whenever I start typing a command, for example get, I can use the tab key to get proposals for which commands I might like to use. And if I continue writing get wd, then you see that this list is narrowed down to the commands that are still likely to be meant. And if I am selecting the command I like to use, I can just press enter and the whole command is written in there. And also this auto-completion works with the file system. So for example, if I want to change to the directory 03 here, I can open the equation marks, type in this. Partly is different in different operation systems, but you probably know how to change paths in your operating system. You can start typing two points to get to the higher hierarchical level, and then press again the tab key, and then I can use auto completion here again. But it actually doesn't make sense with get wd, it might just make sense with set wd. And what is also available here on the console is a history of programs that I used. So if I use the arrow keys and press up, I can see the last commands that I entered, and I can browse through them and repeat whatever I did, which already makes working with R more convenient, because you don't have to type every time the commands, but you can repeat what you did. And this becomes even more convenient if you use scripts, and that's what we actually will do in the future from now on, to write scripts of your OR commands. And to do so, I have to open a new file, a new script file, and I can do that by clicking up here and choose R script here. You can see there are a lot of other possibilities up until, for example, making a presentation or a C++ file or so, but we now will stick to the R script here. When I do that, my console part down here becomes smaller, and up here there's an editor part where I can start typing commands. For example, if I repeat that with the get wd command, you can see also in the editor up here the auto-completion works. Then I have the command here, but I have written that here, and now I press enter, nothing happens. And that's quite normal, because we're here just in the editor part, and whatever you type in here, and when you press enter, nothing is executed as such. If you want to have one of these commands executed, you have to go to this line with the cursor and then either press run, or as you probably can't see in the video, there will be a help tool hint that says you can also press control and enter to run this line. So either I press here run, then you can see that the command is executed down here, so this part is pasted in the console and executed, or I can go to the same line and press control enter, then it's also executed. And with this you have your history of commands in a file, and later on can repeat the whole thing, because I also can, let's say, set WD to session 2, make sure that we're there. I can also highlight the whole list of commands that I have here in the file and click run, and then all these commands are executed down in the console. So with that you can program R and whatever is necessary to do your analysis. Usually there are multiple commands necessary to conduct an analysis, and you can all put them in the script and then later on repeat the whole thing if your data has changed or so. Okay, now let's one thing, you can also change the working directory within RStudio with the help of the file viewer down here. You can, for example, make new files and new folders, delete and rename files, but you also have more. And in the more tab, you can see here, for example, go to working directory, and then this thing here is switched to our actual working directory that we have set. Or you can also use set as working directory here, and then the same command is executed that we did by hand here. So setvd is pasted in the console, and then we're at this working directory that we have just chosen here. Okay, R is a statistical program, so it should be able to do calculation. That's absolutely true. You can, for example, type 3 plus 3 in here, and then execute it by pressing Control Enter or hit the run button, and R is calculating, right? So we have 6 here. You can also make this a bit more complicated, for example, having longer equations here. And if I do that, you can see that also this is calculated. And if I insert some brackets here, then also these brackets are considered right. So multiplication is executed before addition, but if I put them in these into brackets, then also this is respected. So with that you can use R as a simple calculator. Usually calculators have also more elaborated functions, for example, like calculating the square root of something, and for this we need a command because there is no kind of short symbol available here. And for doing so we can just type in sqrt for square root, open the brackets because we want to execute a command, and put the number that we want to square root, calculating the square root from, inside the bracket. If I execute that here, you can see that it is rightly done. And I also could chain these commands. For example, if I want to have the square root of 3 to the power of 2, which should result in 3 again, it is executed like that. So whatever is in the bracket is executed as such, as in total, and then the result is the new parameter of the function that stands outside of the brackets. To have an idea how different function works, there is the built-in help functions. You can highlight a command and press the F1 key, and with that you get here two a help file, and these help files are all structured the same way. You have in which package it is, general description or a general title for the command or the commands. Sometimes multiple commands are tackled with one help file. A description, what it's doing, how you use that, which arguments the function take, and then a description of the arguments. So X should be numeric or complex vector or array, whatever this means. We will have an idea about that later on. Some details about the calculation and also references. And that's very nice in R, that for every command you have a citable reference. That probably doesn't make so much sense with square root, but later on, if you use more complicated algorithm, all the time there is a reference to literature, so you can cite what specific flavor, for example, of correspondence analysis you were using in your analysis. Then you have also some people that like to use this function also would probably like to use that function. Related functions that are displayed here, and then an example part. And this example part, on the one hand, shows you very practically how such a function could be used, but also you can execute this stuff here either by just copy paste that into your script or your console, or you can run the command example of sqrt, and then this part here is executed in the console, and you can see the results of these examples here, and probably also if it produces a plot here. I already said we have the function name and in the brackets the arguments of this function. Let me go to another function, that's the log function. For example, the logarithmic, calculating the logarithm. And if I execute that here, you probably might have expected that it goes to logarithm of 10, to the base of 10, but it goes to the natural logarithm by default. And if you want to check out what the default values are, you also might like to consult the help file. There you can see here the log defaults to the natural logarithm as base, set here already with this equal sign. So whenever you see an equal sign in usage here, you know that this is the default setting of this parameter. So the number that you want to calculate with, and additional parameters, additional arguments for this function are called parameters here, or arguments in a way. And you can also see here what they should be shaped like, or what the function accepts. So for example, if I put in here base equal to 10, I get the logarithm to the base of 10. And I could also leave out this base, because from the order in the usage, it becomes clear that the first argument is the number that I want to take the logarithm of, and the second argument is the base. So I could just go like this and it would have the same result. So let's get back to our natural logarithm. And when you calculated something in R, of course, you could write that down and later on use this number here in further calculation, but that's quite inconvenient. It might be much nicer to store them in a way to later on use this and not always have to use pen and paper for that. And for this, there's the very important concept of variables here. So whatever comes out of a command can be stored within a variable. And I call this here my log. This is the variable name. Oops. And put in, have the function on this side, and here I have the sign that gives that attributes the value, the output of this function into this variable. And I like this way very much how it's written in R. You could also use the equation sign, that's possible, but this is much more speaking, I think. So you literally put whatever comes out here into this. It means typing an extra two characters instead of one, but that's not too hard. It makes the whole thing very picturesque, visible, and also the equation sign is has a bit different use in R. So usually use this here, for example, when temporarily setting something to something else and not to store stuff in a variable. You can still use it in R nowadays, like you use this arrow here, but I think this is more clear, so I will use that later on still. Okay, now we have put our the result of our logarithm. I have to run that first. Now the result of our logarithm is stored in the variable, and you can also see up here, I mean, it has changed before when we ran the example, but now we can see here the variable and its value that is stored here in the environmental tab of RStudio, which is kind of a nice overview. You could also see what kind of variables you have defined by typing the command ls for list, and then you can see here a vector of the different variable names that are currently stored in R. If I want to get rid of this double x, I can also remove this variable by the command rm for remove, and type the name of the variable, and execute it, and you can see now this is gone here. And also if I go up again here and execute ls, you can see that's also gone here. So with remove you can get rid of variables you probably do not need any longer. And actually whatever is in R is in the end a variable. For example, if I take my square root here and just execute this part before the brackets, or I could just take that out and put it here and execute that, I can have an insight into the function that is executed with square root. And this time this is not very speaking, because the function actually is done in C++, programmed in C++, so it calls just this C++ routine. But if I, for example, use the ls command and don't put brackets behind it, you can see what ls is actually doing in clear programming language, in the R programming language. That now at the moment doesn't probably mean so much to you, but it is one of the advantages that you can always look into the specific algorithm and get an idea what the algorithm is doing with your data, different from other proprietary statistics software where you usually don't get the real implementation of the algorithm. So with this, a lot of the analyses become much more scientific, because you can check what is going on with your data. Okay, so now you know that everything in R is in the end a variable. And if I put some brackets behind that, it becomes a function that is executed. And if I take, for example, my variable that I used upstairs, that I set up above, and I run it as a command, there is an error, because there is no function associated with this variable. It's just a plain number that's in there. So you can kind of use the same variable names for functions and for variables without interfering, but usually it's better, much more clearer, to just avoid the names of functions as variable names. Okay, and now we have stored here a value in this variable, and we can now use that later on for additional calculations. So if I want to have my log and make the exponent of that, I get back, for example, to this 100. So I replaced the actual number by the name of the variable, and then the content of the variable is used in whatever function or name, function or equation I put in here to do a calculation with that. I could also, for example, do my log plus 10 plus 100, and then I get the result here. So you can replace actual numbers with the variables, and with that you can also chain your commands that you can do quite complicated calculations with that. I think that's enough for now. Next time we might discuss about the different kinds of variables or the different possibilities to store data, even more complicated data than just pure numbers, whole data tables, for example, and variables, and how we can work with that.